In this video, I'm gonna show you my 5 top tips for streamlining your PDF remediation workflow. Welcome to the Accessibility Guy channel. My name is Sean Jordison, and let's jump into the ring. Now, the first thing we're gonna look at is how to rename tags. It's come to my attention that not everybody renames tags the same way. So the way that I like to do it is by using my F2 key on my keyboard. So if I want to change this H1 to like an H2, I could do that. Or this P tag to an H1, I could do that. I simply down arrow to the tag, press F2, and then I can change my parent tag to whatever I want by just typing into it. So if I wanted to change like the heading structure, or maybe I want to fix what I just did, I can backspace, push F2, delete H2, and just kind of work on the contents here as I get through the content. And over time, you can be very quick with this. After you're done making your selection with the F2 key, you simply press enter to make the selection. Next, I'm going to show you how to add alternate text for all of the links document-wide with just a few simple steps. To do this, we're gonna select the print production button, then we're gonna select pre-flight. I'm going to leave my Acrobat Pro DC 2015 profile set, and then I'm gonna select this little tiny wrench. And from here, I'm going to search for the word annotation. And there's an option here called create content entry for link annotations. I'm going to select fix, and we're going to have to resave our file. And it's going to put in the link annotation for every single link in the document. And we can validate this by highlighting our mouse over the link to see the entry. And if you wanted to overwrite this, you could right-click the link, select properties, and add in your own alternate description. We could say introduction TOC item and select close. Then we could do menu, save as. Let's go ahead and save this file. Now that method I showed you at first will replace all of them in the document, but if you wanna overwrite it and then come hover your mouse, we've now got introduction TOC item as the tooltip. Now there's another trick I like to do to update content that is sometimes incorrect. This is a fantastic method for fixing acronyms. Let's try this one more time. I'm gonna go down to my table here, into my table row where I have Montana, USA. Now this might possibly read wrong because of the acronym USA. Let's right click the P tag, select properties, and let's update it the actual text because we wanna force the screen reader to read United States of America. So we're gonna say Montana, comma, United States of America. And this is going to force the screen reader to read that correctly. Then we're gonna select close. Now I often get asked, how do I know where to place a tag at? So let's say I was, under famous dinosaurs and this list item as an example. Now, there is a trick for when you create a new tag to have it placed directly under where you click. So if I want a new tag to appear between this H2 and the P tag, I can right click the H2 tag, select new tag, and we can just leave article, that's fine. It's gonna put it right underneath the tag that we right clicked. Here's another example. Let's say I had a nested list item that I needed to put in the L body section of this list. I could right click the container element, select new tag, and I would create a parent capital L tag, select okay, and that would place that element right underneath that container element. So this allows us a little more fine tuning of where the new tag goes. Because if you were to like right click the document tag, select new tag, and I'm just gonna put capital SHAWN, in this example, it puts it underneath the document tag. It's really easy to accidentally lose your place if you don't know that technique. So I hope you learned something with that one. Now let's see if we can find this other error. If your content is split up, like in this example where we have figures associated with dinosaurs, where I added that actual text, if I remove that and we actually launch the screen reader right now, it's going to read this just fine, even if the content element is split. So if the content element is split in the tags panel, let's just launch JAWS and see how it reads.
JAWS micro.
And where we're trying to get to is this line right here, figures associated with dinosaurs.
Heading list guide, contents, enter, enter, heading dinosaurs are some of the most.
And what we're gonna listen for right now is that it's gonna read the next line fine.
Captivated scientists and enthusiasts alike, this document delves into the rich history, notable facts, and figures associated with dinosaurs.
It reads perfectly. So just because the content is split in the tags panel doesn't necessarily mean that it's gonna read incorrectly. Now, if you found this quick tip video useful, please hit that subscribe button. And if you wanna find out more about how I can help you get accessible, take a look at the link in the description of this video. And as always, I could be your champion for inclusion. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I'll see you next time.